And what about motivation? What has that got to do with everything? In the end, the only thing that matters is motivation. Finding those basic desires in people and being able to create conditions for living them in the system of work. The truth is that very little would be produced if we did not have motivation. So it should be built into the workplace, this motivation. It should be intrinsic, coming from inside of people. It makes you work harder when you have it. You know that. It's required for happiness. We cannot be happy if we don't get our psychological needs fulfilled. And it's based on want instead of need. It's something that we want to do from intrinsic motivation instead of something that we have to do because some manager tell me to do it, or I need to do this to get my salary. So what about this intrinsic or extrinsic motivation? Have you heard about that? Well, I would argue together with many other people that there is no such thing as extrinsic motivation. There could be extrinsic triggers that would trigger intrinsic basic needs, like status, for example. If I get a higher pay, I would get a better status. I could buy myself things that would give me the need for status, but it's still an intrinsic need of status. So all motivation is really intrinsic. So it comes from within, regardless of how it's triggered. You don't see the world as it is, but as you are. And this is through your own glasses and through your own value system. That means that we are all biased. We are all basically self-hugging. We think that our own psychological needs, our values, our personal values are the best. And that the world would be a better place if just everybody understood that. You know, so we're trying to impose our own values onto other people all the time. This is our bias. Dan Pink's recipe for motivation in Agile, it's very common to quote Dan Pink when we talk about motivation. I'm quite tired of that because it's so narrow. The definition here of motivation is very narrow. It's very general, very common. However, yes, they do motivate people. Autonomy, master, and purpose do, but it's only to a certain degree. And that degree is different in different people. So not everybody is highly motivated by purpose, for example. Some are, and some are less motivated by purpose. Also, there are many, many more things that motivate people. The tool I'm going to show you is the Rees motivation profile. And Stephen Rees found over 400 motives when he did his empirical research for the Rees motivation profile. So we're going to talk a little bit more about that instead of staying just with Dan Pink's recipe here. According to researcher Stephen Rees, we all have 16 basic needs that we all share in the whole world, just to a different degree. So it goes cross-cultural. And this is empirical studies made in the 90s. So it's modern research if you compare with other similar tests or personality assessments. So over 7,800 people in North America were asked anonymously about what motivates you and what makes you tick. Why do you do what you do, and what would contribute to your happiness in life? These were the questions that they were asked anonymously. And he then collected more than 400 different motives that people said, this is what motivates me. This is why I do what I do. And then he used statistical psychological factor analysis and did this research, scientific research. researched. He wrote a number of scientific articles, which he then published in psychological magazines. And then he released this test in the beginning of 2000. This is the first empirically tested and validated taxonomy of human desires and motives. And each motivation profile is really like a fingerprint. It's very, very individual. I have done over 500 profiles to this date, and I've never seen anybody have the same profile as somebody else. So everybody's totally individual and unique as human beings, which is fascinating, really. You go through this electronic survey where you rate 128 different statements. So it's 8 per basic need. And it takes about 15 to 30 minutes to do it. And then you discuss your results in a coaching discussion with the RIS master. These needs or motives, Stephen Rees is quite practical here. He said that values, motives, needs, basic desires, they are so closely related, so you can't really see any clear difference between them. You want what you value, and you value what you want, he says. So needs and desires, motives and values are so close in definition. It shows your deepest values and also what you need for value-based happiness, and it motivates everything you do. And it occurs with a very varying degree of self-awareness. Some people are extremely aware of their basic needs and some are not. It's really interesting. You don't choose them. They just happen by genetics and by your upbringing. You are shaped until around the age of 14 to 16 years, then they are quite stable in your whole life after that.